But in order to do that, they're going to have to see us not only doing things over there, but being an example for good here, in this world, in this country. And here's a perfect example of that. We have a crisis with global warming in this world, not just in America, but in the world. And we need to, we're 4% of the world's population. We emit 25% of the world's greenhouse gases. We're not an example for good. We're an example for bad. We're the worst polluter on the planet. China's catching up fast. But if we want to go to the developing world and say, this is a crisis, we have to preserve this planet. We have no credibility until we first clean up our act here at home. So here's what I think we ought to do. I think we ought to cap carbon emissions in America, a national cap. I think we ought to bring that cap down every year. I think below the cap, we ought to auction off the right to pollute, to send out any carbon dioxide, as the cap is coming down each year. So make the polluters pay. That's what it boils down to. And then the money that comes from the polluters, that money should be used to invest in wind, solar, cellulose-based biofuels. We ought to put $1 billion in the development of carbon capture technology. And until we have carbon capture technology, there shouldn't be another coal-fired power plant built in the United States of America. We ought to put $1 billion into making sure that America, with union workers, is building the best, most innovative, most fuel-efficient vehicles on the planet. We ought to break these electrical grids, which are largely controlled by big power companies now. We ought to open up those electrical grids and make them available to communities, small communities, to grassroots organizations, to create some competition that doesn't exist today. And then finally, the President of the United States ought to be willing to ask Americans to be patriotic about something other than war. To say to America, if we want to be strong, if we want to be independent, we have to be willing to conserve. We have to raise fuel efficiency standards on our vehicles. You're going to have to conserve in your home, in your workplace, drive more fuel-efficient cars. That's what America should be doing. Here's another